This is a 4Community Bible Talk, preparing us to connect in a community space this coming Sunday at 10:30, only on Zoom.
Welcome back to this 4Community space. Thanks for joining again. Okay, so I totally agree that the lockdown is crazy and it's keeping people apart. I am an extrovert and I am feeling it too, particularly this week. I've been going a little crazy. However, I think there's more to the story. The COVID lockdown, in my opinion, is also the most connected some of us in our society has ever been. We're connecting more now than we were before. We're more intentional about who we're connecting with. And we're connecting with the people that really matter to us. We're not missing those people as much as we used to. And we're more intentional about reaching out. We are intentionally reaching out, where perhaps before COVID, we weren't really. During this moment of COVID, we're more connected because we're connecting and we're not taking people for granted, perhaps, like we were before. But it's becoming more and more clear to me that this COVID moment that we're in is also presenting us with more and more opportunities to connect with others and also to connect with God. So for us in 4Community, us who are connecting as a part of 4Community, this is actually an okay time for us. We can lean into this and we can find benefit and we can be of benefit to others during this moment. For example, my kids have never seen their grandfather as frequently as they're seeing him now. Every single day, they intentionally give him a call. When they're eating lunch or when they're eating dinner, they'll FaceTime him and they eat every single dinner and every single lunch with grandpa every single day. We try to do it over breakfast too, but grandpa wants to sleep in a little. So there's another advantage of this COVID time. People get to get some rest that they weren't able to get before. But my kids are connecting more now with their grandpa than they ever had before. My wife's brother and wife, they just happened to stop by the other day. They stayed in their car. They texted us when they were here. We didn't even know they're coming. They rolled down their window. They're shouting at us. We're shouting at them. They're waving because they needed to get in the car and drive around to help their baby fall asleep. And they're like, well, why don't we just drive by? And it's a huge drive. It's like an hour trip. But if we're going to be in the car anyways, let's be in the car and let's visit. We're intentionally connected with people that we want to stay connected with. My neighbor and I, one of my neighbors down the street, we would connect maybe once every month, once every 2 months. Now we're connecting a few times a week because we're intentionally reaching out and staying connected, just making sure that our mental health is doing okay too. And my neighbor and I were staying on track with each other to make sure that we're leaning into our exercise routine and we don't come out of this being all hunks and all gooey, well, more gooey than I am right now, but we want to be pressing into some kind of diet plan and pressing into some kind of exercise plan, and we're keeping each other motivated. Yeah, I give you those examples and say all that to share this positive thing here, that people are hungry to connect. They desire it. They want it. And we're connecting intentionally. Let me just encourage you not to miss the benefits of this moment. Because of the weight of the virus bringing us really, really low, and we feel the weight of this, and it's lowering our mood. The virus is real, absolutely, and the precautions we're enduring are serious, absolutely. But if that's all that we focus on, we're going to lose sight of what God is and what God can be doing in our midst right now. God is bringing something new in this moment, and God is doing something new in this moment. And if we lean into this moment as people who believe in Jesus, as people who know that God loves us, as people that know that God has a plan for us, and his plan is for us to prosper and to love us and to benefit us. If we just trust that God in this moment has something new to say, and that new thing that he has to say isn't just for us, it's just for everybody, then we're going to see this new time that we're in more of a positive light. We can see this COVID moment as something that's very beneficial. You know, as Christians, we stay focused on what we always stay focused on. That's being a follower of Jesus. We focus on following Jesus. Our focus is on following Jesus rather than following COVID. When our focus is on following Jesus, our perspective is going to become positive. And COVID is going to be less and less the boss of this moment. And Jesus is going to be more and more the boss of this moment. And we start focusing on Jesus, start leaning into what it means to follow Jesus in this moment and to bless people and to love on people in this moment in a new way, because we're not personally physically connecting anymore. Well, we are personally connecting, not physically connecting. When we lean into what it means to be a follower of Jesus in this moment, our perspective's going to change and we're going to start seeing some of the benefits that we can experience right here and right now, if we lean into this moment, trusting that God has something new to do and God has something new to say, and it's relevant and it's healthy and it's a blessing for us, waiting for us to receive from Him. Today, I'm going to encourage you to lean into followership. I talked about the word followership in our last meeting, and I talked about the word followership in the inductive study. If you want to press in a little bit more to find out where the content of this message is coming from and how I dissected the text, I'm going to encourage you to go over to that inductive study following this video and look at how I inductively sliced up the text so you kind of get the behind the scenes of this message. But I'm going to encourage you today to lean into followership and to see and be able to embrace what God is doing in the world, in our society, in our families, in our neighborhoods, right here and right now. My text today is Mark chapter 1, verses 9 through 15. Mark chapter 1, verses 9 through 15. I'm going to read it, and it's from the New Living Translation. One day, Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee, and John baptized him in the Jordan River. As Jesus came up out of the water, he saw the heavens splitting apart, and the Holy Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice from heaven said, "You are my dearly loved son, and you bring me great joy." The Spirit then compelled Jesus to go into the wilderness, where he was tempted by Satan for 40 days. He was out among the wild animals, and angels took care of him. Later on, after John was arrested, Jesus went into Galilee, where he preached God's good news. "The time promised by God has come at last," he announced. "The kingdom of God is near. Repent of your sins and believe the good news." And of course, we pray that God's voice will be the loudest that we hear through all of this. What I want to share with you today is followership essentials. Followership essentials. You know, I know this moment talks about Jesus' time, that 40 days in the wilderness, the 40 days of temptation. It feels like we're in the wilderness right now, but I don't want us to miss what the wilderness can offer us. I don't want us to miss what this time of, like, our 40 days in the wilderness, perhaps, this time of testing, perhaps. I don't want us to miss the benefit that's here right now, because God is doing something new for you and saying something new at this moment. We're not going to become followers of COVID. That's not going to help anyone. We're going to do what we need to do, but our primary leader isn't going to be the virus. We're going to exercise sound-mindedness, absolutely, but our primary focus while we lean into this pandemic lockdown thing is going to be on Jesus. So I want to talk to you about followership, particularly right now during COVID. Followership includes two essentials, okay? I want to talk about the two essential ingredients, pieces, whatever, to followership. If we're going to lean into followership, we need to demonstrate what being a follower looks like just by doing our normal thing. Hold on to normality as believers, continue to follow Jesus so that we can be a demonstration to those around us. What does the Jesus life look like, particularly right now when we're in our desert moment, I suppose, this time of testing? Communicate what being a follower. Secondly, communicate what being a follower is to the people who are now receptive to positive encouragement and really appreciative of someone who wants to reach out and connect with them. Right now, we're surrounded by people who are very receptive to positive reaching out. I mean, even the introverts. This is too introverted for the introverts, I'm finding, that people are sharing, either with me or on social media. When this is too introverted for the introverts, you know that it's a ripe season for reaching out to people and sharing an encouraging word and starting up a conversation. So let's talk about the two essentials of followership and how we can lean into this moment to find out what God is doing, the new benefits that God is doing right now, and the new thing that God is saying to us, and the new thing that God is saying to the community around us. First of all, the first of the two essentials, demonstrate what being a follower looks like. Demonstrate what being a follower looks like. You know, most people are looking for a way to get through this new way of life that we're living in right now. And the way that you do life is relevant right now. I mean, everybody's looking for an idea. How do I get through the next moment? How do I get through this week? Like, I can barely plan 2 weeks ahead right now today. How do I get through this moment? The way that you do life is relevant to everyone around you. I mean, I'm not saying it's the only way to do life, because even you and I who are believers, we do life very, very differently. But it is a way that's valid to the people that's around you and to your family members, to your neighbors, to the people that you're still intentionally connecting with. First, you need to be a follower. You know, once you have heard the gospel message and have believed it, and I'm going to guess most of the people watching this have heard the message and they've chosen to believe in Jesus, we now need to be living repentantly. You know, that's still valid during COVID. We need to be living repentantly. Living as a follower of Jesus is living a new kind of life. And, you know, we're all living this new kind of life in COVID. So this really matters. And this is really relevant. How are you living your new kind of life as a believer? And in ways, you know, those ways that you are relevant to people that are looking for a new kind of life while we're in the middle of COVID. If you're not living as a follower, then you're not experiencing the present reality of God's kingdom, and you're not someone that others can experience the present reality of God's kingdom through. Let me just break that down for you. There are two systems here present in the world right now. There are two kingdoms here present in the world right now. There's the system of the world where, you know, for example, when somebody hurts us just a little bit, we'll hurt them back a lot more. And there's this crazy cycle. When somebody does something that we perceive as hurtful, we then respond in a way that's even more hurtful. And it's compounding hurt on hurt. Or you can choose God's kingdom and God's system, which is a system based on love and forgiveness and mercy and grace. If we want to live as followers of Jesus, we need to act like followers of Jesus. If we want to be in God's kingdom, we then take on the role of a citizen of God's kingdom that's right here, right now, in the, you know, it's present right now, and we do as citizens will do. I mean, you could live any way you want to. If you want to live the way the world lives, go ahead. Go ahead and live the way the world lives, but you're going to miss the benefits of God's kingdom. If you want to be in God's kingdom, which is present right here, right now, we need to be living as followers of Jesus. And when we live as followers of Jesus, what happens? The benefits of God's kingdom applies to us right now, and we're also relevant and helpful to the people around us. So we can live however we want to live. But if we want the kingdom of God to be relevant to us and to other people, we need to be followers of Jesus and be living repentant lives, even in the middle of COVID right now. Followership includes repentance. You know, there are things that we have done or maybe that are doing right now that don't belong in God's kingdom, that don't belong in the lifestyle of a follower of Jesus, because they hurt the relationship and they just don't belong in God's kingdom that's present right here, right now. Kingdom citizenship means the adoption of kingdom values, which includes what goes into our heart, which goes into our mind, what goes into our social lives, what we're expressing in our activity. All of that counts. Our entire being needs to be brought into alignment with our new citizenship. So live as a follower of Jesus. Adopt the mindset of a follower and lean into what it means to follow Jesus. Lean into what it means to be living in a spiritual kingdom that's present right here and right now. The second essential within followership is communicating what being a follower is. We need to communicate what being a follower is. We don't have to look far right now to find people who desire to be connected with in a positive way. They're all around us. We all want to be connected with in a positive way right now. So even if you accidentally text somebody that's not you, you dial the wrong number or something, you text somebody that may be received positively right now because people just want to connect and they just want some kind of positive interaction right now. At the moment, most people will respond positively to any encouragement that you want to pass along to them. You know, just be yourself and reach out in ways that are natural for you, because your style of communication right now is probably going to be very well received, because everybody wants to communicate, not everybody, but most people want to be communicated to in a positive way right now. You know, in order for someone to receive and to follow Jesus, they need to hear the message. And the hearing of the message really relies a great deal on those of us who will step out in agency, those of us who will choose to see that, yeah, God's kingdom is physically present right here and right now, but nobody can see it, they can't touch it, they can't taste it, they can't hear it, unless we demonstrate the reality of the present kingdom of God that's right here, right now. We step out into agency. Would you please communicate the presence of God's kingdom and invite people into it? Remember, here's why you and I need to communicate in some way the presence of the kingdom of God right here. Because one can't experience the presence of the kingdom of God unless they experience it through you. You and I walk with agency, the same agency that John the Baptist had in the first passage of Mark, the same agency that Jesus has in the second passage of Mark that we're looking at today in 9 through 15. We need to step into agency just by being a follower, just by demonstrating what followership looks like and communicating and inviting people to join in the kind of life that you have embarked on. Let people experience God's kingdom through you. Let people experience someone who has the experience of God's present kingdom right here and right now. And let people see how valid this is. Let people experience the kingdom of God through someone who is experiencing the presence of the kingdom of God right here, right now. Let them experience that through you. God is doing something new. He is moving. COVID hasn't stopped God. COVID doesn't have us beat. I'm not saying it's not serious. It's serious. Exercise sound-mindedness, grace, mercy. We are in a time right now. However, COVID doesn't have us beat. COVID hasn't stopped God from working. God is just doing a new thing. And one of the things I'm noticing that God is doing is he's helping us to connect more than we were connected before. We are more intentionally connecting with people that matters. We're more intentionally trying to encourage one another and check in on people's mental health, mental well-being. Well, you know what? Your Christianity, the fact that you are a follower of Jesus, is very relevant right here and right now. And just by allowing people to see the way that you live your life right now and how well you're doing during this pandemic moment, that's valid. That's relevant to people. So go out on a limb. Step into agency. You know, knowing that people can experience the presence of God's kingdom right here and right now through you. You do walk with that kind of agency. Have a little confidence in God that you are more than what you think you are, because you don't just walk alone. You walk with the Holy Spirit. As an agent of God's kingdom, God is working through you. And particularly in this moment of pandemic, God is doing something new. And if we could just lean into this and trust that God is doing something new, and he's got something new to say, let's lean into this, let's embrace this, and step out in agency. Okay, here's the takeaway to drive it all home, sort of. It's not easy, but here's the takeaway. Embrace followership, demonstrate followership, and communicate followership. I know it's big. Embrace followership. You know, you and I need to be followers of Jesus so that God's kingdom is relevant to us right here, right now. We receive the benefits of God's kingdom. Just embrace what it means to be a follower. Follow Jesus. Demonstrate followership. You know, live your life in a way that is going to help somebody else, be positive to somebody, encourage somebody else. Say, look at the way I'm doing life. I know it's not perfect. I know it's not all there is to do, but it's really relevant. It's helping me right now. I can invite you into this too. You know, communicate followership. Maybe what I'm doing is going to be helpful to you. You know, the stuff that I learned about Jesus, maybe that's going to be helpful to you too. However it is that you communicate, just communicate as yourself. However it is that you pitch it, just it's not even a pitch really. It's just, this is how I'm doing life. You know, maybe it'll work for you. Well, I guess it is a pitch. Anyways, there you go. So embrace followership, demonstrate followership, communicate followership. You know, I always think that I do a better job in the inductive studies than I do in these shorter messages. So if you want to see behind the scenes and how I've dissected the text, please go to the link that's in the sort of in the show notes of this YouTube video. Click that link and it'll take you to the inductive study where I break the text down. Okay, that's it for today. See you Sunday at 10:30. As we connect over Zoom, remember that we consume content ahead of time so that when we connect in Zoom, it's just all about connecting. and we get to debrief our week. We get to talk to one another, pray about what matters to you, go into breakout groups so the teens connect with the teens, the kids connect with the kids, the adults connect with the kids. However you want to do the breakout works, groups is fine. We're creating community spaces so you can connect with others and so you can connect with God. So please join us Sunday at 10:30 for a personal invite. Send me a direct message and I'll send you the link to our meetings online. Only on Zoom for now. All right. See you next time. Walking up.